for that.
Ah, come here. You're gonna get married
mother,
again.
Mother.
Come with daddy.
Woo! Hi, greetings. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Family.
For you, Jenny Hilton.
You would have worn the prettiest shirt.
Ma.
I know, you come as you are.
And look what book he has.
Oh my God.
You need to sit. We have chairs for you.
That was our Bible for our
I know.
Animals. We know that.
That's yeah. Wonderful.
Oh my God.
I guess I shouldn't wear sunglasses.
It's too late. Don't show
your... Show your... I
want to begin by reminding you that we are who we are because of whom we choose to love. And because of those who choose to love us. On this 60th wedding anniversary of our renewal, let us begin with a prayer. Creator God, we acknowledge your presence here and within the hearts of Jerry and Betty, everyone else present. We know that your love unifies and that this unifying and attracting power is what has led Jerry and Betty here to publicly declare their love and commitment to each other again. We are grateful that you have blessed their marriage for 60 years, and we know that you will continue to do so. Blessings of Bonnie and Ginny Starkle, and John and Jessica, Alyssa and Brian, and Mike, cousin Linda, Susan, Julie and Stephen, Ellen and Leah.
Jack.
Sharing, perseverance, humor. A marriage that is an opportunity to grow and unfold in the company of someone who loves and accepts us just the way we are, and who sees the infinite possibilities in all of us. To be loved and accepted is a very special thing. Loving another person is a deliberate, conscious act of commitment. It's something we must refresh and renew every day. And you, Betty, and you, Jerry, have certainly done that for the last 60 years. It is caring as much about the welfare and happiness of your marriage partner as it is about you. It is being sensitive to the thoughts and needs of the other. It is about sharing the joys and successes as well as the sorrows and the failures. Jerry and Betty, when you first joined hands and hearts 60 years ago, and having known each other for at least 10 years before that, you did not know where life would take you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through all things. Life has surely brought you your wonderful blessings, difficult tribulations, and a wonderful family that loves you. Provided the planning for this very special surprise today.
You're going to get eaten.
Something you will never forget. You have fulfilled your promise. God is smiling. And now as you begin a new life in this beautiful place, it is most fitting that you renew the vows you made in New York City in 1953. And Jerry, won't you have this woman to be thy wedded wife? To live together in the holiest state of matrimony. Will you love her, comfort her, honor her and keep her, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and keep thee only unto her, so long as you both shall love
her. I will. A little more help,
you can all do it, Betty. Betty, will you please respond to your husband? Do you love this man to be that way? To live together in the holy state of matrimony, or to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to keep him home only unto him, so long as you both shall live. Jerry and Betty, do you have anything you'd like to say to each other at this point?
Wait.
No kiss.
You didn't even get your ring.
That's what he wanted to say.
That's what he wanted to say.
Go ahead.
We'll say it privately.
Give him to Bob.
We're just blessed.
Okay.
We say it all the time. We're just blessed.
That's what we should say every day. If it's not love, what blessed?
Exactly.
And even heavy finger.
Our parents, grandparents, everyone was a role.
You certainly are for your family.
Don't make the man cry.
She's doing just fine.
Tell them something.
So congratulations.
Like congratulations, Grandma.
Thank you, sweetheart.
You love me, right,
you're
Grandma?
You're my sweet girl.
I am?
You're my beautiful, sweet girl.
Can I give you a hug, Grandma?
You sure
can. Okay,
okay.
Oh, I love you, Father.
You go.
Yeah.
I love you, Bob.
Thank you. I'm honored.
You know what your name
is? Jerry. Last part of the vows. I, Jerry, take thee, Betty. I, Jerry, take thee, Betty. To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer and for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. Thereto I pledge thee my faith. Betty, looking up to Jerry, you please repeat after me. I, Betty, take thee, Jerry. To be my wedded husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better and for worse. Richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. Thereto I pledge thee my faith. As part of the ceremony, you must remember, or maybe like many brides and grooms, you don't remember much of the ceremony, it was a little whiskey until after. But for 60 years, you have kept the commitment and the fidelity that you promised to have. So, the second part of our ceremony today is the blessing of these rings. Now, these rings remind us of one thing, especially. These rings remind us of the symbol of your love and the fidelity that you have presented to you, each other, all those years. These rings are the symbol of the endless, spiritual, and unbroken love that links you both all these years, spirit to spirit, soul to soul, in joyful life. With this ring,
with these rings,
I make you my life's partner, my wife. And with this ring, I share with you all the treasures of my mind, my heart, my hand. Betty, would you please take Jerry's ring?
Betty.
The fourth finger of his left hand, holding it, repeat after me. With this ring, I make you my life's partner, my husband. And with this ring, I share with you, eternal God, creator, preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual
grace, the band,
and the author of everlasting life. Send thy blessing upon this woman and this man and this family, whom we bless in thy name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant made between them, that they may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and to live according to thy laws.
Hey, say Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov.
And I present to you again a renewed bride and groom, Jerry and Betty Cohen. Congratulations.
Tell you no lie.
How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? How many times a day do I think of you? How many roses are sprinkled with dew? How far would I travel to be where you are? How far is the journey from here to a star?